Okay, for this video, I will going to discuss isa sa favorite topic sa Criminology Board exam, and that is the institution of criminal action. Or sa Tagalog, paano ba magpa-file ng kaso? Kailan ba ikakandak ang inquest proceeding? Kailan ba ikakandak ang preliminary investigation? Saan ba ipapile ang complaint? Saan ba ipapile ang information? So, ito ay masasagot sa illustration na makikita nyo sa screen. And after that, I will also give sample criminology board questions. So, let's start. If a crime was committed, dalawa yung possible scenario dyan. The accused was arrested without warrant through in flagrante delicto arrest or caught in the act, o di kaya ay through hot pursuit operation. Pwede na naman, the accused was not arrested. So, if the accused was arrested without a warrant, ang complaint ay ipapile kay prosecutor and the prosecutor will conduct inquest proceedings. Paano naman kung the accused was not arrested? Well, the offended party o yung biktima o yung peace officer, yung police, ay mag-prepare ng complaint. Gagawa ng complaint. At saan ipapile ang complaint? Hindi yan automatic ipapile kay prosecutor. You need to consider two things. Is the offense punishable by at least 4 years, 2 months, or 1 day? Or the offense is punishable by 4 years, 2 months, and below? Kasi pag ang offense ay punishable by at least 4 years, 2 months, and 1 day, kailangan ipile mo yan kay prosecutor. Kailangan ipile yan kay prosecutor. Bakit? The prosecutor will conduct preliminary investigation. Why? Because if the offense is punishable by at least 4 years, 2 months, and 1 day, preliminary investigation is mandatory. Ngayon, paano naman if the offense is punishable by 4 years, 2 months, and below? Kailangan din i-consider yung lugar kung saan nangyari yung krimen. Ang crime ba ay nangyari sa Metro Manila or Chartered City? O di kayo nangyari sa province or municipality? Kasi, if the crime is punishable by 4 years, 2 months, and below, and it happened in Metro Manila or in Chartered Cities, you need to file the complaint sa prosecutor. At anong gagawin ni prosecutor? Well, the prosecutor will conduct personal evaluation of the documents. Walang preliminary investigation. Bakit? Kasi it is punishable by 4 years, 2 months, and below. Paano naman kung ang crime ay nangyari sa province or municipality? Well, kailangan mo yang i-file. The complaint should be filed directly with the MTC or the Municipal Trial Court. At anong gagawin ni judge dito? The judge will conduct personal evaluation of the documents. So, example. Ito, example. Teacher, nahuling nagipag-sex sa student. General rule, if the student is of age and the teacher is single, wala namang krimen yan. Because sabi nga ng Supreme Court, the love has its own reason for the reason we do not know. Pero, if si teacher ay 25 years old, si student ay 15, at meron silang carnal knowledge, coitus or copulation, ibig sabihin, nag-sex sila, that is statutory rape. And that is punishable by reclusion perpetua. 20 years and 1 day to 40 years. Eh, paano naman kung si teacher ay 25, si student ay 16? Hindi na yan statutory rape. At na meron silang carnal knowledge or coitus or copulation, ang kaso ni teacher will be qualified seduction. And what is the impossible penalty? That is prison correctional medium period. And that is, the maximum of that is 4 years and 2 months. So, if the crime is statutory rape, diba ang statutory rape ay at least 4 years, 2 months, and 1 day? What if it happened in General Santos City? It's a chartered city. You, ano gagawin mo? You need to file the complaint kay prosecutor. Para saan? For PI or preliminary investigation. How about if the crime happens in the municipality of Basilan? Hindi sa charter city, hindi rin siya located sa Metro Manila. It's a province or a municipality. Still, you need to file the complaint kay prosecutor. Bakit? Because it is punishable by at least 4 years, 2 months, and 1 day. And PI or preliminary investigation is mandatory. Paano naman kung ang crime ay qualified seduction? Diba, ang maximum penalty ng qualified seduction ay 4 years, 2 months lang? And what if it happened, yung qualified seduction nangyari sa General Santos City? So you need to file the complaint kay prosecutor, but no PI. No preliminary investigation, only personal evaluation of documents. Bakit, sir? Because General Santos is a charter city. What if the crime, the qualified seduction happened in the municipality of Basilan? So it is province or municipality. So you need to file the complaint directly with MTC, but no PI, because judges are not allowed to conduct PI. Okay? So that is the general concept of institutional criminal action. Now, let's have sample board questions, no? Application sa illustration. So for example, number one, a person is suspected of committing a crime which is punishable by imprisonment of at least 4 years, 2 months, and 1 day. And the person was not subjected to warrantless arrest. So, hindi nahuli in flagrante delicto, hindi rin nahuli through hot pursuit operation. Pero the crime is punishable by at least 4 years, 2 months, and 1 day. How will you proceed with the case? A. Report the matter to my superior and let them decide what to do with the situation. B. Exert effort to arrest a person even without a warrant for the commission of the crime. C. File direct complaint with the prosecutor's office for inquest proceedings. Or file direct complaint with the prosecutor's office for preliminary investigation. So, well, ang tamang sagot dito ay file direct complaint with the prosecutor's office for preliminary investigation. Hindi pwede ang inquest because walang warrantless arrest. Inquest will only apply sa warrantless arrest. Kaya, ang tamang sagot dito ay file the complaint sa prosecutor's office for PI. Bakit? The crime committed is punishable by imprisonment at least 4 years, 2 months, and 1 day. Okay, let's have another question. Preliminary investigation is a matter of right when the penalty for the crime committed is. So, kailan required ang PI? Kailan required ang PI? A. Not exceeding 6 years of imprisonment. B. Imprisonment of at least 4 years, 2 months, and 1 day regardless of fine. Or C. Imprisonment is 4 years, 2 months, and 1 day regardless of fine. Or less than 4 years. So, ang pwede niyong papilihan dito is yung B at saka C lang. Yung 4 years, 2 months, and 1 day. Pero anong tamang sagot dito? Well, ang tamang sagot is yung letter B. Kasi merong at least. Huwag niyong kalimutan yung at least. 4 years, 2 months, and 1 day. Yung letter C kasi walang at least. So mali yun. Hindi kasi automatic na 4 years, 2 months, and 1 day lang. Kailangan merong at least. Mean to say, 4 years, 2 months, and 1 day, and above. And above. Number 3, the crime committed is punishable by imprisonment of at least 4 years, 2 months, and 1 day. The crime was committed in Metro Manila or Chartered City. Where should the complaint be filed in order to initiate criminal action? Actually, ito yung importante, at least 4 years, 2 months, and 1 day. Hindi kayo importante yung Metro Manila or Chartered City. Because Metro Manila and Chartered City will only be significant if it is punishable by 4 years and 2 months. So, ano mga choices? A. To file complaint directly with the Municipal Trial Court. B. At the police station for a warrantless arrest and inquest proceeding. C. Prosecutor's office for the conduct of preliminary investigation. Or D. File information directly with the Regional Trial Court. So of course, ang gagawin diyan, ang tamang sagot diyan is yung file the complaint sa prosecutor's office para mag-conduct ng preliminary investigation because the crime is punishable by at least 4 years, 2 months, and 1 day. Number 4, the crime committed is punishable by imprisonment of 4 years, 2 months, unless 4 years, 2 months, unless and the crime was committed in the province. In the province. Where should the complaint be filed in order to initiate criminal action? A. File the complaint directly with the municipal trial court. B. At the police station for warrantless arrest or an inquest proceedings. C. File the information directly with the regional trial court. D. At the prosecutor's office for the conduct of preliminary investigation. Remember, the crime is punishable by 4 years, 2 months, unless. So, hindi pwede yung PI. Hindi rin pwede yung regional trial court. Lalo namang hindi pwede sa police station. And it happened in the province. So, saan may papail ang kaso? Sa municipal trial court. Okay? File the complaint directly with the municipal trial court because it's 4 years, 2 months, unless, and it was committed in a province or municipality. 5. If the crime is committed in the province and the penalty thereof is 1, does not require preliminary investigation. Does not require preliminary investigation means to say it is 4 years, 2 months or less. Complaint should be filed where? Directly with appropriate municipal trial court, at the prosecutor's office for inquest proceeding, directly with appropriate regional trial court, or in the barangay first for conciliation proceedings. So here, the right answer is directly with the appropriate municipal trial court. Bakit? Of course, the crime committed is below 4 years, 2 months and below, and it was committed in the province. Okay, 6. If the crime is committed in a province and the penalty thereof is does not require preliminary investigation, complaint should be filed, again, that's with the municipal trial court. 7. A person was arrested without a warrant. Without a warrant. For the crime or penalty, which is imprisonment of at least 4 years, 2 months, and 1 day. He asked for preliminary investigation. What is required of the person arrested in order that preliminary investigation may be conducted? As I remember, if a person is arrested without warrant, ano dapat i-conduct dyan? Kailangan i-conduct dyan yung inquest proceeding. Inquest. Pero, sabi nung arrested person, ayoko ng inquest. Gusto ko ng preliminary investigation. Nag-request ng preliminary investigation. Pwede ba yun? Pwede naman. Pero anong dapat gagawin niya para mag-grant yung preliminary investigation na request niya? A. He should ask for presence of the counsel while being detained. He should ask for his right to remain silent in the course of preliminary investigation. He should ask his right to be informed of the nature or cause of accusation against him. Or he should waive his right under Article 125 thereby spell code. The correct answer here is kailangan niyang i-waive. He should waive his right under Article 125 the revised spell code. Ano tong Article 125? Ito yung 36 hours detention, 18 hours detention, and 12 hours detention. 12, 18, 36 hours detention if arrested without a warrant. But since nag-request ng PI, kailangan niyang i-waive ang Article 125. Hindi na yan mag-apply. Okay? 7. 8. I'm sorry, 8. Alden committed a crime against Cardo. Cardo wants to file a case against Alden. Cardo wanted to find out which proper authority should the case be filed. If the crime committed by Alden is punishable by prison mayor and was committed in Metro Manila, where should Cardo file a case? Prison mayor is punishable by 6 years and 1 day to 12 years. So it's at least 4 years, 2 months and 1 day. So, saan mo dapat i-file yung kaso? Well, kailangan i-file ang kaso sa prosecutor's office for preliminary investigation. for preliminary investigation. 9. What if the crime committed by Alden is punishable by 4 years, 2 months and was committed in Metro Manila? Metro Manila. Where should the case be filed? So, saan dapat i-file ang kaso if committed siya sa Metro Manila and 4 years, 2 months lang yung impossible penalty? So, you need to file it with the office of the prosecutor. Bakit? It is the crime happened in Metro Manila. 10. What if the crime committed by Alden is punishable by 4 years, 2 months and was committed in the province? Where should the Cardo file the case? So, kailangan yung i-file yung kaso. Si 4 years, 2 months siya and province, kailangan niyang i-file yung kaso sa municipal trial court. Okay? That will be all for this video, no? For more discussion videos for your preparation sa incoming KMLG board exam, you may visit my YouTube channel. Marami din ako doong mga final coaching videos. Thank you and good luck sa board exam.